No, you are praying, oh God, let this message, let the service be mine. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
When you go to the conference by 4 a.m., you are awake. The brothers used to wake us up. You hear some brothers praying, and you feel like it's not when you are not praying and they are praying. You begin to pray. And they told us, no Bible, no breakfast. That's how the youth pastor used to tell us. He said, no Bible, no breakfast. Now, if you don't eat Bible, you don't eat breakfast before you read the word. Not like today, where by 12 or by 1 or by 6 p.m., you have not read the Bible. I'm telling you, you can't say you don't have time. You have time. You just have to make it. I hope I'm not offending anyone. It's not my intention to. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We have to go back to the foundation. We're talking with the bishop. He said, there's no patience today. Someone said, you want to be born again on Monday, be baptized on Tuesday, be ordained on Wednesday, and you know, do everything and die by Sunday. You want to do everything now. Hallelujah.
Amen.
No, Peter, all these guys, they took 3 years before they began ministry. Who in church today can serve your pastor for 3 years before they make you a pastor? You come to church for a month and you want already ordain me. I'm not offending. I hope I'm not offending anyone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We want to go back to the old time revival.
Amen.
The old time revival. Amen.
Amen.
Old time, right? Amen. Can I say old time in another church, but a new school? Can I say old time, you know, God? As our old time, you will never find scared in church. I'm not offending you, sisters.
Amen.
You will never find a privilege in church.
Amen.
No. Huh?
Amen.
Because of money scared in the church. The church of God. Never. No one will tell you, when you wear it, I'm a sinner. The Holy Spirit will tell you.
Amen.
Today there are not dresses, but the sledge is here. We were discussing this with my wife and like, there's no fashion. I want to say, please now God, can you come close? Please. There. Here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Clap hands for the men of God. How many realize that this is not about Moses tonight? It's God.
Amen.
All these anointed people, do you think they came to me? This is God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So what I'm saying is that I'm asking the Lord to give us the all-time revival. Hallelujah.
Amen.
How many remember the Bible? The Bible says after they had prayed, the place was shaken. Huh? The place was shaken. Even Jesus himself, the Bible says he prayed to the point where he began to sweat. What kind of prayer was that? Huh? Jesus, sinless, not wrong of me with my weaknesses. He was sinless, but the Bible says he left us an example. I'm telling us that as he is, so am I. But you don't want to follow him to get the money to pray. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me, but you don't want to go through Corinthians. I thank my God that I pray with Christ more than you all. Follow Paul everywhere, not just follow him where it's convenient. Hallelujah.
Amen.
How many of you have heard Pastor Chris say, he said, talk in tongues. He will tell you, pray in tongues. When he tells minister the secret of ministry, he says it's easy. Pray in tongues. Pray in tongues. Prayer is still the key. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we just want to make sure that we pray. We're going to pray. I'm trying to just prepare you to pray before we do anything. Who is ready? Ask anybody ready to pray?
I'm ready to pray.
You may surprise me now. We are going to intercede. How does that work? Let's pray for souls. You will hear the volume will go down. Huh? The volume will go down. Let's pray. Oh God, give me souls. Because we have, I don't know, Let's pray for the government of South Africa. We will not take it serious. I command my helpers to come. You will hear the volume. Money enter my account now. But you know, there are people who said, you hear men of God say, I never pray for money. I'm telling you the truth. What they do, they make sure that they follow an assignment. Because what happens is that our success is in the success of someone else. I'm telling you the truth. The moment you discover your purpose, I want to help make someone else's life better. In the process of that, you will have your own success. I'm telling you. Because it says he gives seed to the sower. So what you need, just your eye decide to become a sower. Seed will follow me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
May you discover your purpose in this service.
Amen.
I said, may you discover your purpose in this service.
Amen.
Your amen is not good. May you discover your purpose in this service.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Do you know that if God gives you now, gives you a prophecy and tells you your assignment, you are done. You don't need anything else. Because that's one of the serious errors we have in life. You don't know your assignment. What a painful way of life. Or you don't know what you are here for. I was saying, someone, last year was a beautiful year for me. When God confirmed my assignment, which I knew, but when God confirmed it prophetically, I told someone, I said, I'm ready to give pastoring to my guys, pastor. Me, I'm an intercessor. I'm okay to stay in the room and just pray for you. I discovered what I'm living for. I'm telling you the truth.
Amen.
I'm ready to allow my boys to do pastoring with yours. Me, I will pray for you in the room. And that's why I am here to volunteer to be your intercessor, some people here.
Amen.
You will never say no one is praying for you. As you are here, I'm volunteering, I will be your personal intercessor.
Amen.
And I began to say, I will begin to follow intercessors as well. When I heard a man saying he prayed for 28 hours, I said, oh God, you're not born again. But there are levels. The man said he prayed for 36 hours, Pastor Lewin. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We will get there. Say, I will get there.
I will get there.
Say again, say, I will get there.
I will get there.
I want us to be hungry. You know what? When I get to the Bible, never get to the point where last year where you are yesterday is better than your today. How many understand that? Where you are yesterday is better than your today. It's a mistake. When you say in 2010, I used to. What about today? You have forsaken your first love. You have forsaken your first love.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You will be restored.
Amen.
I said something will come on you.
Amen.
Fresh oil is coming on someone.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They have revival without media. I'm going to pray for women here. You will have mantles, like mantles of Catherine Kuman.
Amen.
See, the sisters are not receiving this.
Amen.
What I'm telling you is a prophetic word.
Amen.
This meeting here, I began to pray for this meeting last year on winter. And one of the things, the Holy Spirit said, there will be mantles in the spirit. What do you mean mantles? People who shook the world. Mantles don't go back to heaven like that. They must remain here. Anointing is not needed in heaven. We need it on earth.
Yes.
Are you listening to me?
Yes.
So the Holy Spirit, there will be mantles here, such that there will be some people here, your gift will announce you to the world.
Amen.
And I'm looking about years to come. Just between now, I will give a prophet. Next year by this time, someone, nations will know your name.
I receive.
I'm telling you, doors will open for you. Someone will say, I will sponsor your gifts. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But we are going to pray. And we are here to pray that even ministers that are not here, that God to be an example of unity.
Amen.
That the success of my brother should not intimidate me.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
I'm telling you.
Amen.
When God blesses your neighbor, it's the fact that he's in your neighborhood. I'm
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So happy for all these ministers here. Do you know that if we are here now, all of us here, if God says, let's help one of our ministers here to do anything, maybe to build a church, this ministry is not supposed to be difficult. The problem is that we are not biblical. We are not biblical. When you read the Bible, you discover that the church in Thessalonica will contribute and help the church in Jerusalem. How many of you are reading the Bible? The apostles will go and say, let's take the contributions and take them to where? To Jerusalem. But how come ministries are suffering? Because we are building personal empires. I'm telling you the truth. Revival comes when the man of God was saying it's all about Jesus. The bishop. That's why I say there are many ministers all over, but there are people that have a special place in your heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The bishop is a good man. He's my good friend for close to 15 years now. Blessings. You know, it's not easy for friendship to stay that long.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said it's all about Jesus.
Amen.
In other words, I'm not trying to build my name.
Yes.
That's why, even when we're talking about something also about mentorship, that mentorship is not about you becoming a photocopy of me.
Yeah.
No, it is me helping you to become the best of you.
Yes.
Even if you're going to be greater than me, my joy is that you get my child.
Yes.
Are you listening to me?
Yes.
And at the end of the day, when they want to celebrate you, they want to ask, who is your father?
Amen.
I can't spend to be at the end of the day.
Amen.
Are you listening to me?
Amen.
Every parent wants their child to be better than them.
Amen.
Unless you're a witch. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we're going to pray. We're just going to have some sessions. There are people who have allocated to take some sessions. And then after that, we'll worship. And the prophet of God is about to minister for us.
Amen.
Prophet Eric. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This man is from Mafindeni. In our first church, where Apostle Maposa gave me a church, this man came to my first training center. Now we get him, he's a pregnant of God. Amen.
Amen.
And I want us in his absence, to please celebrate Apostle Maposa for what he has done for us. For me not to acknowledge him.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, you have to honor the anointing. We're discussing with the prophet of God that you must understand that God will never release, you know, the same thing. I don't know, how will I put it? If he gives a gift to a man, he will never give the same thing to another person like that. No. How you will get it is by connecting to the man who already has it. Who has it? Your problem is pride.
Yes.
Why do you want to construct your own roads instead of using the one that's already constructed?
Yes.
There's already S4. Why do you want to invent your own electricity? The Bible says John the Baptist came with the spirit and power of Elijah. Where does the Bible take the audacity to call the message the power and spirit of Elijah? Is it no longer the spirit of God? No, do you know that we will call it a problem, the spirit and power of a man of God? We're not saying. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I don't know. I want to offend some people a little bit. We're discussing that, you know, some of us have a problem with the God of my father. Some of us have a problem with that. And the only reason you have a problem with that is pride. Because you say you want to have your own God. Paul said, my God shall supply your needs. He didn't say our God. So if you're in the Philippian church, you say, me, no, I want my God. you will not get the blessing that is upon Paul. Because he was releasing the blessing that comes from my God, him as Paul. Do you see the enemy's true Lord? Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you see, look at this. Please listen to this. It is better to be a small part of a big thing than to be a big part of a small thing. That's powerful.
Yes.
If you look at someone, for example, great men like Mandela, who there are streets that are named after him, I don't know, many things, not streets, strictly too small, universities. A man who is celebrated by the whole world. If God gives you the grace to be half of him, you know that you have achieved in life. Who knows what you could have been if you don't become the half of my neighbor? I'm not saying you should be that, I'm just telling you. That there are people that if God gives you the grace to be half of that man. We're talking, for example, about Brian Agbonke, a man who has won 100 million recorded souls. 100 million recorded people souls. If God gives you the grace to become a quarter of that name, do you know what that means? 250 recorded souls. Million. How many understand what I'm saying? It's an achievement. It's an achievement. There are people that you look at them and say, God. Not that you have to forget yourself, but what I'm saying is that you have to appreciate what is on someone else. Hallelujah. Iron sharpens iron. Amen.
Amen.
So, I hope the people who have the intercession pamphlets are ready. Amen.
Amen.
Are you blessed?
Amen.
Are you blessed?
Amen.
Okay, I'm whole. Whatever you come out. Hallelujah.